So to begin, I gotta teach you the basics. It's the things that we use with the verbs in order to make them reflexive. We have me. Me we use for I, for io. Then we have ti. Ti is used for you, for tu. Then we have si. Si is used for he, she, and it. However, they also say yi, yi, which is gli, and then there's also le, le, which is for she. Yi for he, le for she, because it's like lui and le, le for she. Then there is chi. Chi is for us, for we, which is noi in Italian. Then there's vi. Vi is for voi, which means you guys or you all. It's simply you plural. But we always say you all and you guys because it makes more sense to explain it that way. But it's simply you pluralized. And then we have si. Si for they, which can also be used for he, she, and it. However, for the most part, they always just say a loro. To they or to them. For example, if you want to say to someone, do you understand me? Do you understand me? You say, mi capisci? Mi capisci. Because literally we're saying, to me, do you understand? Mi capisci. To me, do you understand? That's why we say capisci, because it is the you form of capire. If we just said capisci, it means you understand. So in order to say to that you understand me, we have to put me in front of it. Mi capisci. To me, do you understand? Always have that in your head. To me, do you, or it's to somebody. Then, let's say you want to respond. You say, yes, I understand you. You can say si, which means yes. Ti capisco. Si, ti capisco, which means yes, I understand you. Ti capisco. Si, meaning yes, ti capisco. To you, I understand. So now let me just give you some more examples of phrases. To say I wake up at 7 o'clock, you say mi sveglio alle sette. Mi sveglio alle sette, because it's I wake myself up. Sveglio means I wake up. I wake up. So we say mi sveglio because it's I wake up to me. I wake up to myself. I wake up myself. If I ask you what's your name, I say come ti chiami? Come ti chiami? This literally means how do you call yourself? Come chiami ti? You see how that's why I'm doing my hands like this. I don't know how the words will come up when I edit it, but I'm just trying to give you an idea. We're saying, how to yourself do you call? Come ti chiami? Because chiami is you, the you form, and we're putting ti in front. So it is you call yourself. How do you call yourself? That's what it literally would translate to. Now we're going to talk about he, she, and it. So you can say, for example, he likes something, right? You can say, gli piace. Gli, it's kind of like a yi kind of sound, the gli. Gli piace. Gli piace mangiare. He likes to eat. Gli piace mangiare. We can say, le piace mangiare. She likes to eat. Le piace mangiare. With we, you can say, ci sentiamo. That is, we will hear from each other. We will hear ourselves. It's a way of saying, we'll talk to you later. We'll talk soon. You can also say, ci siamo capiti. Ci siamo capiti. That means we understand each other. Because it is, ci siamo. We are, to us, understood. Now an example with vi, which is from voi, you, all, plural. Cosa vi porto? Waiters say this all the time in Italy. What can I bring you? What can I get for you guys? Cosa vi porto? What to you guys can I bring? What to you all can I bring? You can also say, if you're not really good with putting the vi in it with the reflexes, you can say, cosa porto a voi? What can I bring to you guys? You see how it's interchangeable? And then for they, it's always better just to say a loro. For example, they like to swim. A loro piace nuotare. A loro piace nuotare. It means to them, swimming is pleasing. To them, swimming is pleasing. A loro piace nuotare. So, I hope you guys understood everything in this video. If you didn't, feel free to leave a comment or send me a message. I read all comments, read all messages, and maybe I'll respond to yours. Thanks a lot for watching this video, guys. Be sure to share it with everyone that wants to learn. And click like on my official Facebook page. Thanks, guys. A presto!